Hello, Hoos, and welcome to John Paul Jones Arena, where the Virginia Cavaliers have just defeated the Virginia Tech Hokies by a score of 73-55. This means that for the third season in a row, the Hoos have swept the Hokies in men's basketball. I'm Miranda Mason, and this is The Cutting Edge. Now, before we get back to men's hoops, let's check in for the first time in 2013 with the Virginia football team, who just signed 24 new players as their 2013 recruiting class. To celebrate National Signing Day, which took place this past Wednesday, Coach London and the Hoos hosted an event right here at JPJ in which the community could come out and hang out with the coaches and the players. On National Signing Day, the Hoos invited the Charlottesville community to come out to John Paul Jones to meet players and coaches. The entire team was on site to sign autographs for fans, and parents and kids alike took part in the festivities. Morgan Moses and Luke Bowenko even handed out raffle prizes to fans. Of a Wahoo fan are you?
Oh, season ticket holder, 4 years in a row. I'm a fan.
So how great is it to have an event like this where you can come out and meet the players and get introduced to the new recruiting class?
I think it's a great idea. I like the concept. It's nice to see them in this element, so it's kind of fun.
I've been a fan ever since I was little.
Do you go to all of the games?
I try to. It's a heck of a drive from Richmond, but I haven't missed a home football game since I was little.
Hey, how big of a Wahoo fan are you?
Not really big.
How big? Can you, this big?
Even bigger.
Do you know anything about the recruiting class?
Not much. I guess I'm here and there.
Now to jump back to men's basketball, after playing and defeating both Clemson and Maryland, today's game against the Hokies was the third in just 6 days. The standout star of tonight's game was Joe Harris, who scored a career high of 26 points.
No, I thought it was impressive. It made me look like a good coach when he comes out and plays like that. He had great rhythm. He was hunting the shot, moving hard off the screens. And he really, I thought he got us off to the right start, because we played hard, but defensively we were out of position, a little late on some rotations, and gave them good looks. And we even took some, I thought, a couple of ill-advised shots. And I think Joe's start at least kept us in the game, because they hit some shots, and then we settled in a little bit better and defended and moved the ball. But that was a very, very impressive, the way he was moving and shooting. I love seeing that. And again, we needed that to get off to the right kind of start.
It's 9 points. We'll take it. He's when he gets on fire, he's on fire. And he came out guns loaded this game.
I think he hit like three threes in a row, the first 9 points, and he just got us off to a great start.
I mean, you just get yourself in a good rhythm, and that's a testament to just your teammates. They're doing a good job of getting you open. You know, guys like Akil, Justin, the bigs, do a good job of screening, and Jontel does a great job of finding it, and he's really good at getting into the paint and making my job easy as a shooter. Yeah, I mean, that's what we talk about quite a bit. When we're practicing and working on our shooting, is fighting for your feet. It's really important to get your feet squared up to the basket. That's the first thing that as a shooter I think about, and something that our coaching staff has done a good job with all of us, and the rest is just as long as you can get your eyes set on the rim, I think I have a good shot at going in.
And of course, this week on The Cutting Edge, we cannot forget about freshman Justin Anderson. Let's check in to see what he and Coach Bennett have to say about his growing and instrumental performance on the court.
And what I like is he's aware of when he either takes a bad shot or maybe has a lapse. And as of all of our young guys and all of the guys on our team, when they're aware of that and we can kind of get them to self-correct, or at least say, I know that, that's a big deal. Because sometimes young guys are just trying to survive. They're just trying to keep their head above water. And I think our younger guys at least are starting to grasp the idea of how important, a breakdown, or how costly a breakdown can be. And that fight in your mind to be free from that is really important. So I like it when I see those guys responding the way they are. And, yeah, Justin's given us a nice lift, as have a lot of guys. And with Justin having to slide and guard fours more, that's kind of what we've adjusted to defensively. And his ability to use his body and get on the glass and rebound for us, it's very important. And then, you know, what he's doing offensively, giving us some versatility, has been equally important. So I think he has a grasp of it, and I think he knows his steadiness is what's key. He's got to be real sound out there, as all the guys do, and I think that's where he's growing.
I don't know. I'm just out there, you know.
You don't hear the buzz at all?
No, I'm in my own little world out there. If you see me laughing and stuff, I'm just in my own little world, you know, just talking to myself throughout the game, you know, telling myself little things. And, you know, I just, during timeouts and stuff, when I hear the crowd get a little loud, then that's when I start, you know, engaging with the crowd a little bit. But, you know, I'm just out there in my own little world, just trying to do whatever it takes to win. Yeah, I mean, I'm all about the team, and it's all about our team win. You know, that was a great bounce back from going out there and losing to those guys. And they're a great team, and not take away anything from them. But I think we really came together, and we were really tough tonight, and that was a great collective team win.
Right around the corner, Davenport Field has seen almost $1 million in improvements in the offseason to support a team that is returning 19 letter winners. They will play their opening game on Friday at East Carolina. The lacrosse team has been ranked number 9 in preseason polls, and they will also play their opening game this Saturday at Klockner Stadium against Drexel. For the Cutting Edge, that is it this week. I encourage you again to tweet your suggestions to either the Sabre or me at Miranda Lee. We'll contribute in any way your ideas that we can to the show. Until next week, I'm Miranda Mason.